Hello everyone, I'm again back here with a new video. So this video is also actually a follow-up of previous one. So today also we are going to learn about some numerical problems related to velocity and acceleration. So if you have not watched the previous video, please first of all go through that. And now let's start. We can do that here. So these are four equations of motion. So I have talked about this in previous video as well, right? So there are three equations of motion which are listed here. And for today, we are going to talk about the second case. Okay? So in the second case, what is given? The condition is, if a bird is thrown vertically upward. So if a bird is thrown vertically upward. Okay? So what will happen there? In that condition, the acceleration of the body will be negative of acceleration due to gravity. Okay? And second one, the distance covered by that body will be equal to the height of that body up to which it has reached. Okay, so these are two conditions which are used in second case. And while using these conditions, we can convert these all four equations of motion into this one. Okay, so we have used this one to convert this to this. So these are the output while converting this into this. Okay, so you can do that and you can find out these things. Okay, now let's start how to do numerical problems. Now please look at here. So the question is given here, a stone is thrown vertically upward. So this case is given here. With an initial velocity of 20 meter per second, you can directly write here, given initial velocity u is equal to 20 meter per second, right? So when you throw a body or any object vertically, then it reaches to its final velocity at 0 meter per second, because it will reach the ground. That's why you can directly write that final velocity v is equal to 0 meter per second. Okay, I think there is no condition regarding here. Similarly, what is asked here? Find the maximum height it reaches and time taken by it to reach the height. Right, so what are asked here? Maximum height. So, h is equal to what? Secondly, what is asked here? Time taken is asked here. Time taken, t is equal to what? So these two things are asked here, and also it is already mentioned here the value of acceleration due to gravity is 10 meter per second square. So you can use this as well. So first of all, just find out which formula must be used to take out these two things. Okay. First of all, now look at here. Height of the body is asked, right? You can use this formula. Initial velocity is given, final velocity is given, but time is not given here. Right, in this position also time is required. So first of all, you have to find out the time taken here. So you can use this formula to take out the time. Okay. So as we know that v is equal to u minus gt, we can directly put down a value here. V is equal to 0. U is equal to 20 meter per second minus g is equal to 10 and time is equal to t. You can directly write it. And by calculating, you can directly find out here v is equal to 20 or t is equal to 20 by 10 seconds. You can directly write it 2 seconds. So the time taken that we have taken out is actually 2 seconds. This is the answer for this. Similarly, now we have already got the time taken. Now you can use this formula to find out the maximum height it reaches. Okay? Again, we know that h is equal to u plus v by 2 into t. Or s is equal to u is already given at 20 plus v0 by 2 into u second. Or x is equals to 10 into 2, x is equals to 20 meter. So these are the values that we have taken out from this numerical problem. So I think this one is very helpful for you. Okay? And regarding all the questions regarding this problem, I think you can solve easily by using this technique and by using these cases. Okay? So this was for now. And for the next cases, I am going to talk about that in the next video. Okay? So till then, take care.